I'm head of technical and business planning for AIS. Firstly, I would like to thank each one of you for joining this webinar on Industry Connect, which we have started to connect with the eminent personality from the industry to share the knowledge as well as the experience amongst us. We all know that the world is facing a difficult time due to COVID-19 today, and all the businesses have been affected, and it's being affected as on date as we are speaking. AIS has also taken several precautionary measures as prescribed by the government for the past few weeks and the whole of the April month as well, to ensure the safety in health of the employees, the customers, as well as the partners. We all are taking all the possible steps to minimize the disruption to business and to ensure a smooth restart as and when the environment returns to normalcy, which we are sure that it will be very soon. Let us try to utilize the time and resource that we have at hand and make the most out of it. We also hope that each one of you and your family are safe and healthy and will take all the possible precautionary measures. Coming to today's webinar, so we have Mr. Ashu Gupta with us today, who is the managing partner as one of the leading green building consulting firm, which is designed to occupancy service. It is my pleasure to introduce him, who will be taking up a very interesting topic on Factory for Future, a sustainable option. So this topic itself is a very unique topic for Indian context, because we never have thought about a factory shade with glass. We just look at factory shade with that PEB sheet or something, and we cannot even think of any factory shade with glass. And now talking about sustainability, so it will be not right for me to talk about sustainability when we have Mr. Gupta, who is the expert on that. So he definitely will throw a lot of light on that. But before starting the presentation, I'll take this opportunity to talk about AIS. So if we'll see this slide, so we are the leading integrated glass company, which was started in 1984. And during its more than 35 years journey, we are able to establish 12 plants and sub-assembly units, which caters to the glass requirement for automotive as well as architectural glass requirement. Today in the session, we will be talking about one which we have recently made. And we believe in customer first approach by keeping complete clarity in the communication as well as in the relationship. And this actually is reflected in the guiding principle, what we tell. And this guiding principle talks about the continuous improvement, understanding the customer's requirement, keep on improving ourselves, creating the values for all the stakeholders, keeping the customer satisfaction at the pinnacle of the KPIs. These are the key guiding principle, which clearly talks about the customer centricity. And if we'll go to the next slide, it shows the presence. In the next slide, if you'll see the overall value chain, so we are present in every part of the value chain in the automotive as well as in the architectural glass. We are present in each and every touch point of the customer, whether it is B2B, whether it is B2C, and that's how it makes AIS one of the leading integrated glass company, where we are not only talking about the glass, we talk about the solution. And we are here to give a kind of solution rather than any product. And that's what we will see in today's presentation also. So without taking much time on this, we'll start this session. And before this session, I would like to introduce Mr. Ashu Gupta, who will be enlightening us on the importance of sustainability by taking the case of a factory building, which as I already mentioned, that it is AIS recently made factory in Gujarat. And talking about Mr. Gupta, his career spans across several diverse domains, and it will be very less time for me to actually introduce him in detail about his capability, but I'll try to put the crux here that he, from the academic point of view, he is a mechanical engineer. And as I mentioned, that he's the managing partner in design to occupancy services. He is a very active volunteer in various building engineering society like ISHRAE, ASHRAE, FSAI. Very soon, very recently, I have got this opportunity to attend one of the webinar, which was really interesting, where Mr. Ashu threw a lot of insight on the topic. And apart from all these details, he is a great trainer, and that actually makes him a best candidate for such kind of webinar. He has trained all more than 8,000 architects, engineers, consultants, and government officials. So knowing something and spreading the knowledge are two different things, and Mr. Gupta has both of them. Talking about awards and recognition, so he was nominated as ASHRAE's Young Face of Engineer in the winter 2013. He received Rajasthan Energy Conservation Award for contributing to state energy conservation effort in individual category in December 2014. He also received Uttar Pradesh Energy Conservation Award for contributing to state energy conservation effort in individual category in 2018 December. And he received the Developing Leader Award by ASHRAE in January 2019. These are few of all the recognitions what he have got. So Mr. Gupta, I would like you to take over from here and give us the insight on today's topic. Thank you so much.
All right. Perfect, Shailesh ji. Sorry, your voice was breaking in the last, so I didn't, I stopped in between. So first of all, thank you so much for giving my nice introduction to everyone. And I welcome each and everyone for this amazing session, because which I'm going to talk about the new future type of industries which we are making. And I thanks to AIS team to inviting me on this platform. And I can see the lot of people around the world, I think, already joined and joining in every second, one person is increasing on that. So this is my background. He has already did. So my experience in the last 12 years, I have done several green building projects, several sustainability projects, a lot of energy modeling, lot of third party commissioning in HVAC system. So in, of course, the 12 years is not a much experience, but in the last 12 years, I fortunate to have a different kind of projects in my career. And I have done more than 300 green building projects in around the globe, in which I was involved directly and indirectly in that. So and the training is my passion. I always love to teach or train people in with the basic terms. I never go in the detailing manner, but definitely whenever something, I try my level best to explain that. The before to start a presentation, just want to give the housekeeping announcement. There's a question and answer tab in the panel, and whenever any questions coming in your mind, just write the questions there. We will take the question and answer session once my session will be over. So the last of 15-20 minutes, we will have a question and answer session. So the today presentation, so I want to brief about my company, which is the Design to Occupancy. It was a startup in 2013, but now it is a full-fledged company and working globally presence. We have around 75 people, or we are working not only in India, we are doing several energy modeling projects for around the globe in US, in Saudi Arabia, in SAARC countries as well. And we are doing a lot of green building projects, either the LEED, IGBC, GRIHA, SOCHM, or the CPWD. Consulting, and now increasing in sustainability way to more and more people should incorporate in that. All right, so the question directly comes to the green building in a factory rating, right? When we say the green factories is a word, because in earlier we have seen the different kind of factories, mostly shaded factories, no daylighting, no glass. And is my just want to share that is my voice is clear, Shailesh ji, just confirm me, because hello Shailesh ji, can you confirm just my voice is clear?
Yes, it is clear. I am able to hear you.
Perfectly fine. All right. So this is the green factories. We always have seen in our prior, priorly, that different kind of factories we had. No one focused earlier. I know a lot of MSMEs building or some big factories also. No one thought about the daylighting in the building. No one thought about, because this seems, how can we make such kind of new energy efficient design building? So my presentation today will be the case study, of course, no other than the AIS factory, which we are doing in Patan in Ahmedabad. And that factory, how we are designing, how we did energy and daylighting analysis in that. But green building, just a basic to inform everyone, is not a new concept in India, is very old concept. And we say the green building is only those building if we save the natural resources of our mother earth. But what are the natural resources? In Hindi, we say the Jal, Vayu, Agni, Prithvi, Akash. In English, the names are different as per the different rating system. Some people say the sustainable side, some people say the integrated design. But at the end, in the crush, the green building is those building which saves natural resources during the design and the construction of the project. Those buildings are the green building. And how we can make those building? My focus today presentation, not on the detailed one, but definitely we will be focusing only on the energy and daylighting part. That how the energy and daylight impacts, how the glass impacts in the building, way to design, how should we do that? So this green building rating system, just for the educational purpose, we have several green building rating system in India and around the globe. First, one name which is very common because all the world, entire world focus the LEED certification, which is called Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design. We have IGBC also, the Indian Green Building Council, which gives the rating system. Similarly, we have also the GRIHA rating system in India, the Green Rating Integrated Habitat Assessment. And the another rating system, we have a ASSOCHAM GEM, which is the Green Environmental Movement from the ASSOCHAM part. Recently, another rating system from the CPWD, because earlier the CPWD, most of the buildings were following GRIHA norms, but now they also started their rating called GHAR. I did a last week one training session for entire CPWD officials, and that they made a very basic concept of the GHAR rating, and they want to understand all those features. So there are the different rating system, but in general, when we say mostly famous for the factory purpose, and we talk about factory, the LEED, we have seen the lot of LEED factories in part of the world, like in Bangladesh. I have seen in last few years, every textile factory is going for the LEED certification. So this is worldwide happening. Because why the reason this demand is coming up? Because right now the entire thing is depend on supply chain management. Now, if someone wants to manufacture some product in their factory, their client has a requirement that your factory should be a sustainable. And this is, I have seen, because in my consulting career, a lot of clients comes up that this is our requirement, minimum requirement from our client. They want to work only those buildings which are sustainable, which are green. So this is, we have to understand. So similarly, what incentives, why should we go green? A lot of people already knows about the basic things, but I won't say factory owner, why they should go green. The factory owner, the best benefit, of course, they will conserve some energy because operational cost is very high in the factory building. And if you don't make up green things or the sustainable features in the building, your building operation cost can be very high. Either is the water, either is energy, or the thermal comfort of your equipment. So of your employees also, employees as well. So this is, we have to take care, that's a factory. But sometimes the developer says, why should I go green? Because I don't need to live in the building. I will sell out the building. But now these days, the government is giving a lot of incentives. Some of the states are giving 10% extra FAR, some are 5% extra FAR, some are 15% extra FAR in India, I'm talking about. So the developer get direct benefit when they design or construct a green building. So this is the reason a lot of developers is focusing in that direction. The third reason, marketing, because when you do a you project yourself as a sustainable development. I had a very great panel discussion with the 9 countries people last week, and that was the topic was COVID-19 is an opportunity for sustainable development. And I was reading several articles right now. Every day I'm coming up with one article. Every country after COVID-19 is focusing on green awareness. Every green awareness going on, they will focus on sustainable development only. Because this pandemic is not just I would say the pandemic, it is a warning from the people, with warning that I think something more worst can happen how we are using our natural resources. Either it is asset value, like project cost. So when we say the green building project, the buyer, the charge some premium on the cost as well. Like I am also living in a one of the platinum rated project in Jaipur, and that project is an additional charge the developer asked, but I paid because I got a proper daylighting, I got a proper ventilation in the building. And this is happens if the project opts for any green norms is that than the conventional building. So this is some rating system which have a different criteria. I'm sure a lot of people always seen the certified silver, gold and platinum. And this is the difference when the certified achieve the 51 to minimum level is certified, and the maximum if they have any building have a more than 80 points, they get a platinum rating. All right. So I'll talk about the LEED BD plus C. The LEED is a leadership, energy, environmental design, building design plus construction, and version 4. They have a these criteria: integrated process, minimum energy performance, optimized energy performance. This is I'm talking about the glass impact, because a lot of people always think that the glass, how the glass impact on the building, and this we have changed. So we want to understand from the energy point of view and the parameters point of view what we have to understand. In any green building rating system, the glass impact related to these credits. So integrative process. The first integrative process, we say the basic envelope attributes. The reason behind it, lot of energy, because any commercial building or any commercial building, the maximum energy goes in air conditioning of the building, around 50 to 60%. And that air conditioning load comes because of your building envelope. Building envelope comprises wall, roof, window. Wall, roof, window. And it actually impacts if how your window wall ratio, how much is your WWR, what is your glazing characteristics. Like lot of MEP consultant never ask that what kind of glass architect is using, because those parameters always impact the heat load calculation of any building. And these parameters I will tell you and explain what kind of parameters impacts, but glass plays a major role. The reason behind it, the glass having a direct radiations heat comes up as compared to the thermal conductance, which are the U value, but glass also have a SHGC value, which is called solar heat gain coefficient. I will explain you in your detail in the next slide. But these are the some glazing characteristics which we have to take care while designing our building, and the integration should be there. That value should be properly communicated to the MEP consultant or the HVAC consultant, because that HVAC consultant can incorporate that value in the heat load calculation. Most of the time they have a prepared sheet and they just don't change. They just change related to the things from internal load, either it can be the lighting or the equipment, but the glass plays a very, very important role in the HVAC load calculation. So I will go on that integrative process. The second, which is the minimum energy performance, very major thing, because the envelope commissioning is also one of the part of LEED BD plus C. And in the envelope commissioning, they says your glass testing should be by from your third party, and how your glass should not having any infiltration or the leakage. So this kind of commissioning also the glass related credit which matters. The third is the optimized energy performance, building envelope glazing, which I talked about, because it directly impact your air conditioning system. It directly impact of your energy consumption. So what kind of glass, what kind of orientation, what kind of WWR window wall ratio should I use in our building? This is we have to understand, and this is comprises an optimized energy performance. Similarly, they have a credit building product disclosure and optimization, which is called EDC, like environmental product declaration, EPD. and they have that manufacturer should be local, source as least 5 different manufacturers that meet the disclosure criteria. So this is also related to the glass purchasing. We have to take care. So the major point, because glass is a thing which gives heat also in the building, but which gives light also in the building. A lot of people say that why we should use glass. We should not use glass, but you need light, because this is the case study available on the Google. You just find it. If you treat a patient in any basement area, or if you treat a patient in any daylight proper room where the daylight is coming, the patient recovery is very fast if you are getting a natural light in the building. A lot of people are doing the artificial light in the building, but actually you feel very productive when the daylight is coming in the building. Always, whenever we choose our flat, when we purchase a flat, when we purchase the office, we always see the window should be there and window should have the light. That is the reason we have to use the glass, but we have to use the way with optimization of glass, that how much will impact on energy, how much impact on lighting, and accordingly we should choose. That is the reason the glazing selection is very, very important part in any building, because it directly impacts on your light and the heat. So I will also focus on that area and the quality views, because the glass has a property which give you the proper view to see outside and connect to the natural outdoor environment. So this is also is the criteria in LEED. So you can see the glass approximately impact on 9 to 10 LEED points out of 100. So it can increase or decrease your rating system which you are targeting. So that is the reason we have to do the effective selection of glazing. Now, how should we do that? So I'm going to showcase you a case study, which is the factory of Asahi Glass, which we are doing right now, and already did the design work, entire simulation. So we did a lot of studies for this project, not only the energy related, we did the climate analysis, energy analysis, daylighting analysis, and the most important part, always the client asks, the payback and the return of investment calculation, that what is my return will come up if I do such kind of investment. And we suggested the conclusion and the recommendation. A lot of people doesn't know that what is actually this picture showing. This is the picture from the energy simulation software. Energy simulation is a virtual method to design a building, where before construction a building, if your design is complete, if your design is going on, you can build up a model in a software related to envelope, lighting, electrical, HVAC, and get the energy consumption. Very few people in India is actually working in this software, and this impacts a lot of value. I'll give an example. One of the project I did in Jaipur also, that is a commercial building. In that also, the similarly the glazing problems comes up. The glazing problems, I told you why. Because the architect was suggesting to the client to go with the DGU glass all side. The DGU glass all side, and I was the consultant, energy consultant for the project. Client asked me, Ashu, if I put a DGU, my cost will be this much. Can you suggest some options? So I did an energy modeling, and in energy modeling, we saw that architect has given a proper shading devices. They used proper overhangs, and in the some direction, we calculated heat load. The direct heat is not coming in that direction. And we come up at a conclusion that with the two sides with the DGU and the two sides with the SGU, around the client saves 22 to 23 lakh rupees in a one single selection of the glass, that what should they use in that. And this is because of the heat load. When we calculate the direct heat is not coming because of the overhang and these things, and we save that money. And the client is still, every time he says that this is the single selection, but not only glass, you can do so many changes in energy simulation related to your electrical items, related to your HVAC item. So whoever is in this industry as an architect, or they should definitely learn as a energy simulation software, which is also the upcoming lot of webinars are happening on that direction. So what we did, the first, I'll give you the background of the project. This is the Greenfield project, is a new construction project. Land area was around 53 acre. Some timing in the project, phase 1 and phase 2 and phase 3. The entire project cost was around 660 crore rupees, and the location 2 hours from the Ahmedabad airport. So this is some location. This is some rendering image of the industry, how looks like. So this project we applied in the IGBC Green Factory Rating System, and IGBC Green Factory Rating System. Of course, we did a project registration, and how we were trying to do a different method to optimize in the design. Earlier, the people were thinking. Earlier, the designer, of course, was thinking to have a PEB structure with some portion of the glass. So we calculated how the PEB structure and the glazing selection, WWR, does an impact on energy. So we did that kind of analysis for this specific project because this is a glass factory, and we want to see the result, how the glass impact in the building. And AIS has the commitment to save energy with the using, of course, with this, how can they maintain the energy consumption with the use of different type of glasses. So PEB with partial glass, so we did some glazing on the north and east facade, and the pre-engineered building with partial glass use of west and south facade. And how we did that. So this is the some this is the checklist, basically. IGBC Green Factory System, they have a six different criteria which I was talking about, which is Jal, Vayu, Agni, Prithvi, Akash. The water is a Jal, energy is Agni, indoor is a Vayu, site is a Prithvi. So this is the basic. They have a different points in that. Out of 100 points, this project is targeting 82 points, which is the platinum rated, which is targeted, and some of the doubtful also, because we did some feasibility. This is possible, this is not possible in the different criteria. So we did, but out of 100, the lot of points are still targeted and pending. Site selection, water conservation, energy conservation, and material and indoor environmental quality. So this is kind of climate analysis we did for this specific project, because this is in Patan, which comes under the hot and dry climate. You can see the weather file, because in any energy simulation, we have to incorporate the weather file, which is the climate condition of that. So that file we import in the weather. We import. I'm sure that some of the polls are coming in between. Please fill those forms on regularly basis. I'm not looking on those, but I will discuss after this session. So in the driver temperature, you can see the lot of area in the Ahmedabad comes in the red area, which is a high temperature, which is because this is a hot and dry temperature. And during this hot and dry temperature, we have to do some kind of analysis so we can reduce the heat coming from outside, and how can we maximize in that way, because the Patan experience a hot and dry climate as per the five climate zone in all over India. And you can see the from the sunrise to sunset, most of the time we have a red area in that city throughout the year. So in the climate analysis, we found definitely the temperature, the air temperature and humidity, how they are varying in this temperature, because the Ahmedabad and the direct radiations. If you look at the second graph of mine, which is called direct solar radiation and resultant illuminance in is high is Patan. So you can see the average one, the recorded low and the record high, which is the direct by watt hour per square kilometer per square meter. So whenever we do the radiations, it comes with the called watt hour per square meter or per square feet sometimes. And this is comparing how much lux level we are getting, because we need light also in the building. I have seen several factories which they do entire concrete or the PEB structure thing, and they don't have the light inside during the workers are working. During the daytime also, they put lot of artificial light in those areas, and which impact on direct energy consumption. So we try to did some analysis that how can we reduce our artificial light, also how can we take the natural light in the building with that. And of course, with the controlling the heat ingress, because heat we don't require. Otherwise, the people, because this is not an air conditioning factory, this is a air. Most of the factories are air cooled, or in air cooled also the people cannot meet the thermal comfort criteria. So we have to meet comfort criteria within the limit as per the NBC guideline or the ASHRAE guideline. So that is, we have to take care how can we reduce those things as well. So some energy analysis assumption, because the plant was around 25,000 square meter shop floor area, which is huge, and approximate 7,000 square meter warehouse area. And parameters have been assumed because glass generally select based upon the some properties. The properties is like U value, which is called a thermal conductance, SSGC, solar heat gain coefficient, VLT, visible light transmittance, and the color of the glass. So this is, we tried different and different revision. So we tried and tested on the simulation. Then also we see on the during the construction also we see something. And we also need to follow the codes, what the green building code or the ECBC code is talking about. The skylight roof ratio with ECBC says not more than the 5% of ECBC of the entire roof area, which we some of the skylights also done. And the model of reflects the actual design of the projects. We have also assumed the miscellaneous equipment, same like office computer, laptop, printer, whatever. We have taken account on that. And we put up some of the HVAC load. But not for the detail. We are talking right now about the glass. How does it impact? So this is the values you can see. Wall U value for the pre-engineered building sheet was around 5.605 watt per meter square Kelvin. Similarly, for the 50 mm, they have a underdeck bubble insulation during that time, not the rock wool, bubble insulation. We also tried with the bubble insulation. So they have some kind of the U value. And this is the single glaze unit glass U value, double glaze glass U value, and you can see the shading coefficient value also. The shading coefficient 0.36, 0.28, 0.28. And these are the other things like a building controls and the building schedules are constant in both the in all the cases. We tried and tested and calibrate as per the SGU, DGU, combination of SGU, DGU. Different kind of the WWR, 20%, 40%, 60%. So this is analysis we did during that time. So you can see some of the case descriptions. The case description, the first case when we talk about 20% WWR, which is the window wall ratio. The way most of the people understand that, if you want to understand, the window wall ratio is the total wall area, all direction, north, east, west, south, divided by the total north, total wall direction and the total entire window area. So if you divide the entire window area divided by total wall area, you will get the window wall ratio. So in that case, the 20% WWR means that your entire wall area having only 20% glass or 20% windows. So that is the 20% WWR. So we tried first case with the clear SGU, which is the single clear single glazed unit on the north and the east facade and other facade having a PEB sheet, because we understand as per the orientation of the building, maximum heat when we talk about. Area, so we can save what kind of glass or what, where we should put our maximum light we can optimize from these north and east direction. So PEB structure on the west and south facade and the north SGU will be the north and east facade with a single case is the base case. This we has taken as a base case, which earlier we were thinking that this is a generally normal building. Assume that most of the normal manufacturing unit assume this kind of case. But in the case second, we decide that building with having a 60% WWR, which is the window wall ratio, high performance DGU, which is in AIS, they have a green radiance plus and the chroma plus used on the north and east facade and PEB in the west and south. The third case was the window 60% window wall ratio, high performance SGU on the north and east facade and PEB on the west and south facade with the partial glasses. So you can see the U value and SSGC value of the high performance SGU. So in a lot of people having a myth that SGU doesn't have a SSGC value less than 0.5, but some of the SGUs in AIS in Asahi Glass you will find less than 0.5 also. So 0.36 they have a value in the high performance. The case four is the 40% WWR performance DG on the north end. So these are the four cases we have taken with the different class properties, that how the much does it impact on my building, and different color also, that because they want a color green properties. So these are the our analysis intent, that this is our intent. Now what results we got. So this slide is very important to understand, because then we did an energy simulation with the all four cases. The first cases we found the energy consumption was around 5,139 kWh in 2000 annually. And the cost per annum, if we talk about the costing wide, the costing was around 400 lakh rupees annually. From in the clear as you, we get this kind of the cost of construction, because there is a cost of construction which is around 6.4 crore rupees for the single glazed glass. But when you go with the second option, the 60% WWR DGU, the energy consumption, of course, you are using a high efficient DGU glass as compared to the SU, your energy consumption will be go down, which happens the 4,346. Cost will also go down, which is the 3.43 crore rupees. And the construction cost will increase. It will up to the 8 crore rupees. But the energy difference and the construction difference we have seen. So never select a glass just only because of energy consumption. You have to take care of the cost optimization also. So this is, we have seen the around 15% energy is efficient than the single glaze DGU, single glaze glass over the DGU. So the ROI was around 2.54 years. The case three, the 60% WWR with high performance SGU. Understand, high performance SGU. The cost will definitely not increase much, is only the 6.85 crore as compared to the 8 crore, and we get around 11% saving as compared to the baseline, which is the 20% WWR. In the fourth case, which we use the 40% WWR high performance DGU. So in this case, we were getting a 9% saving with the sum cost. This is only just related to energy, but we never select our glass just for energy. We have to also take care how much lux level will come on our building, because that lux level which impact on our electrical on our light. Case second in terms of the energy saving, because we have to take care both parameters, construction cost, how much increasing, how much energy we are saving. So in this case, the case three will be coming as a more good option as the energy perspective. So we did a IRR calculation and we found that how much the payback is coming up. So the construction cost is increasing. So after this comparison entirely with the cost, with the thermal properties and all. And after that, we also did the similar cases for the daylighting analysis, because this is also very important to understand the lux level in the building. Are we comfortable? You can make a very good energy efficient building, but if you are not comfort your people, every company spend around 97% of their revenue on the energy consumption or the water consumption or any other consumption. But the main things becomes now these days the productivity of the human. My people should not get absenteeism. So that is the reason daylighting, because the people always work in those buildings. If the daylight is coming, they feel more productive than the conventional building. So 20% WWR with the east for the similar direction, we were getting around 503 lux level. 503 lux level in our most of the occupied areas. Similarly, cost case second, the daylighting, because now in this case we have a DGU. Try to understand. Earlier was the single glaze which having a high VLT. is third, which is the 60% WWR with a high performance SGU, which is the lux level was coming around 1115, around 1000 lux level in that building. And the fourth is the WWR DGU, which is only 268 lux level. As per the National Building Code, every office area should have a minimum 500 lux level. So 500 lux level we can see now, and we can now optimize as per the energy or the daylighting point of view. The case third will be the best option, because the case third we are getting a proper lux value in our on all the areas, and also light and less heat in those areas. So these energy analysis we did, and the case you can see the cost of case third the energy consumption is slightly higher, however the construction cost is less, leading to a lesser payback, and hence it can be termed as the most preferable option, being a financially viable and energy efficient option. So for the green building rating, I just want to mention you here, because most of the green building rating says they have to meet the ECBC criteria, and ECBC having a two option, whole building design option. In the prescriptive, they says the U value should be 3 watt per meter square Kelvin, SSDC should be 0.27, and VLT should be 0.27 is a mandatory, which is not possible in the case three. Try to, and also the ECBC says the maximum window wall ratio is 40%. So this is not possible in the prescriptive approach, and always 99% of the time the people follow with the whole building design approach while designing or the constructing a building. 99.9% of the people, because you have to have the option to change the different parameters. You cannot go with the SSDC, because you 0.2 SSDC in the single glazed glass is very impossible to get that value. So that is the reason we have to take it. So this project was applying through the whole building design approach, in which they have the ECBC says about, and we selected for the case three. So but in the specific case, the client was saying that we want to go with the prescriptive approach also, because we follow the prescriptive is more stringent as the whole building design approach. In that case, they selected the plant should go with the case two option, because of course they are manufacturing in house, the cost will be not a big issue. But when we do our most of the project design cases in different commercial building, always this issue comes up, the costing versus energy consumption, and we have to select accordingly what we have to follow. If your building is the green building criteria, you can also go with the ECBC simulation approach. So this is the note. It is also the use of energy efficient is not only mean the achieve energy saving in the building. Lot of people says I have used the efficient glass. That actually doesn't mean you will get energy saving. You have to optimize the glass. I always give in my presentation, the people now these days making 100% glass building and other things. Glass selection is play a very, very important role. You always remember, because how we select a glass, they have three different, the SSDC, U value, VLT. These are the three parameters which impacts a lot. So always consult with your glass manufacturer when you select these kind of glasses. So this is the daylighting performance we did, is a natural source of light. I am not going in. So in any analysis suggested that we can desire lux level in case one and second. So this daylight analysis, which was showing around it. So I'm going through some glossary, because this is from the ECBC reference guide. You can also refer that what is actually VLT, visible light transmittance, what is U value. You can see with this diagram, the solar energy is coming from the glass. There is a VLT, there is a solar shading coefficient, and which is also the similar as the solar heat gain coefficient, what is U value, and what is the VLR. So this diagram will show you the all parameters of the glass. And glass, you have seen in the lot of railways compartment, we have a two tire, three tire AC coaches, where we have a different kind of glass, which is the two double layer of the glass in the middle of the vacuum. The heat is coming less in the building, in the coach, but you can also not able to visible outside from that glass. And that is the reason in the building also, we have to understand the SSDC and the VLT is totally irreversible to each other. If you go with the low SSDC value, you will have a low VLT also. So you have to optimize with the help of energy simulation software. What should I need to follow with that? So this is kind of the schedule we taken, because the schedule plays a very important role. How much time the schedule and the weather file of that climate, which is the Ahmedabad, that how much it impacts on my building, how much time the sun is on my building. So these kind of parameters impact on also your energy consumption. So this is overall my analysis, which I was discussing about. So I will be more happy to take some questions now, because already I think the 4:45, so I for 15 minutes I will take happy to take some questions. So Shailesh, can you just read out the question for me, and
yes,
I can
yes sure. So thank you so much, Mr. Gupta. So it was indeed a great session and a great insight. I'm sure everyone must have got a great insight, and I can see that with the number of questions which we are receiving. So I'll start with a question which Mr. Chetan Sood has asked. So actually we have covered this part in the presentation, but still if you want to throw some more light on this, the question okay. is how much more would it cost to build a green building after government benefits? How many years would it take to break even or come back to the cost of conventional building? If you want to add something more than what we have already.
Perfect. I think very good question, Mr. Sood. I think I already told that the green building is a movement which started in 2001 in India. And now we are around 20 years happened. A lot of building is already green. When this movement was started, that time the building actually making as a green was expensive. The people who says that time the 10% cost get increased. In 2008, the CPWD increased their BOQ things, and they increased the 10% extra cost for the green perspective. But now these days, because we have seen the technology involvement in the last few years and the pricings are very less. Because most of the projects, if your project is going any for the environment clearance, that project has to follow all the green features. They have to put STP, they have to put rainwater harvesting, they have to put, so there is no additional cost. If they follow the environmental norms, your project can be easily achievable by the gold rating or the silver rating. But if you are targeting a platinum rating, your cost might be increased 2 to 3% now these days, but which can be recovered in the 2 years of the timeline. So the payback, we always say the 2 years if the project is targeting for platinum rating. But you are doing a lot of additional cost now these days, except the consultancy or the certification body fees. You don't need to invest much more on the different thing for the minimum silver rating, gold rating on that. So this is my answer on that. The second question Riyaz has asked, kindly differentiate SSDC and the SC. So Riyaz, the solar heat gain coefficient and the shading coefficient. So these both values are actually is the same without dimensionless value. These are the dimension. There is no unit. Like when we say the heat coming inside the building, so it is a ratio. To convert from SSDC to SC, there is a formula you need to divide by 0.86. Like if you have a value of SSDC 0.25, your SC will be the 0.29. So you SSDC divide by 0.86, your SC will come. In some of the softwares, like most of the manufacturers gives the value in SSDC. They give the value in solar heat gain coefficient. But when you entered an energy simulation software like Equest or somewhere, they take value as SC. So that is the reason we have to convert in both that. But both have the same thing. If they have given SC or SSDC, you can convert with that formula. Right. Any other question?
Yes. So we do have a few more questions. So Mr. Himanshu Bhatt is asking, which software is used for the energy modeling?
All right. So there are several softwares available in the world. Like I will give you some of the names. They are the Equest, IES, Design Builder, Trinces, and several other software. But most in India, if I talk about a specific, because some of the cost, some of the software cost is very high. Like if you talk about the IES or these software, this is a very expensive. Every year you have to pay 2 to 3 lakh rupees. But in eQuest, because in India, more 90% of the people use eQuest software, which is free of cost. Free of cost because they are funded by US Department of Energy. So you can download from their website, you can do, and 90% of the people or most of the authority, either the lead, IGBC, Griha, everyone accepts the eQuest software. So we use eQuest for this project as well, and in which you can also do learning to understand the software.
So one question from Mr. Harish Kumar. Is bubble insulation really helpful or just an eyewash?
Every insulation helps. I'll tell you, there is a just only, please understand the concept of the building physics. If we increase our resistance value, if we increase our thickness of any material or the equipment, like if we say the wall, if we increase a 10 mm thickness increase, the resistance is increased, the U value will be low. So my energy will come low. So absolutely most of the shading areas, most of the shaded factories, maximum people use the bubble insulation as the insulation under deck. So it impacts on the heat. But if you compare with the other things like XPS or EPS or different kind of insulation, you will not compare with the bubble insulation. It's a very 5 mm or 10 mm thickness of the bubble insulation cannot compare with those kind of, but it will impact as per your return of investment, how much you are impact, how much you are paying for those bubble insulation is not eye wash. Because we have seen, we have done some analysis for our building, which actually reduce your U value in that.
Yes, okay, one interesting question from Mr. Hari Krishna Misra. What is the guideline? Select a particular U value, SHGC or VLT value for the glass in facade. Is there an iterative analysis as a part of energy analysis, or in the absence of any software, is there any empirical formula for selecting the?
A very good question, I think, sir, because this is, I already mentioned, only there is a code called ECBC, the Energy Conservation Building Code in India, who has that values available, that this is the minimum U value required. So in the, if you don't want to go with the simulation approach, you can go with the prescriptive approach. In the prescriptive, they have mentioned that this is the U value minimum required, which you can easily calculate with the Excel formula in your, as per your section drawing, whatever the section is available as per your architect, you have designed 100 mm wall, some insulation. So you can calculate the U value with that. And if you achieve directly with the prescriptive approach, you don't need to go with the simulation. You can go with the prescriptive approach as well.
Okay. Mr. Gaurav Varman is asking that, can you share some image of the inside of the plant? So yes, we will be sharing. We will share the complete images of the plant from outside, from inside. And this plant is, as Mr. Gupta has explained, that it is still under construction and it is almost finalized. So once it will be operational, then all further images. Mr. Shubham is asking, are there any big platinum rating project going on in India? How difficult it is to get platinum rating as compared to gold?
Sir, there are several platinum projects in India who is already already certified platinum rated factories or platinum rated commercial building. Earlier it was, when I told you earlier, it was expensive. It is not a rocket science. Very simple in your design. Just as an architect or as an integrated consultant, you need to integrate your design with the people, and you have to do a feasibility. If you work, start from the design, is not very difficult to get the platinum rating. If your building is in the middle of the construction and you say I want platinum, that's not possible. But integration through the design, your architect, MEP consultant should be on the single platform, then very easily you can achieve platinum doing some parameters. Already, if you just Google, do the platinum rated in India building, you will get some case studies available and you can go through those, that how they achieve. So for your information, just want to mention here, because a lot of ITC hotels are already the platinum certified hotels in India.
So one more question is from Mr. Jitendra. Can we use energy analysis for a small residential project, say of 3,400 square feet? What would be the approximately charges for consultation and energy analysis?
Right. So Jitendra, this is the software can be used for anything. I think you want to do a 1,000 square feet office or 1,000, anything you can do. You need to put your energy parameters and get the result. But I'll tell you, software is not a software running is just a rock is just a anyone can run, either the sixth class standard person also can software. But the to understand the building physics is very important. That is the reason the architects and the engineers play a very important role, because they understand buildings truly. So they have to understand how the heat is coming and what will impact on my energy consumption. So this analysis can be happen. And you can learn this, I think that I would say don't hire anyone for the energy analysis for this. If you just want to do your in-house, just download the software, do the practice, and maximum if you have, so you can do your own as well. But if it's not, and for the residential, there is a government tool also available now these days. You don't need to go with the eQuest also. There is a Eco Nivas Samhita for residential building. Bureau of Energy Efficiency has launched the residential energy code, which is called Eco Nivas Samhita. If you just Google it, you will get a one tool which is like a user interface. You need to log in and password and put up your building drawing. You will get to know your energy consumption. It is a very simple tool. So there is, you don't need to hire any consultant for that 3,000 to 4,000 square feet residential project.
Okay, Mr. Pratik is asking whether high performance glass is the need of the day and future factories, as we have seen in this case study.
Right. So, Mike, of course, as per my analysis, the glass high performance, either it can be a SGU, either it can be a DGU. Don't think that a lot of people having the myth that green building says only about DGU. No. If you do the optimization properly, if you understand the thermal properties properly, you can, of course, but your question is the high performance. Definitely high performance, we have to go not only factory, either it will be the building, it will be the anything, we have to go with the high performance glass, because now the lighting part, the comfort level in our whoever the workers are working in the build in the factory, they should also have some comfort area level. The problem happens now these days because of the comfort. Lot of heat is coming because from the machines inside the building, and if we are getting more heat from the outside, the person will not be comfortable to work in that direction. So that is the reason we have to move to the high performance building glass.
One more question from Mr. Pankaj Gailot. So which insulation is approved under green building, whether it is rock wool or glass wool, and reason for others is not considered?
Any companies or any rating system or any code doesn't promote any single company for the insulation. They says only about the U value. That ECBC said you have to meet the U value 0.56, whatever it is. So to meet those 0.56, what kind of insulation you are using? If you are using some glass wool, you have to put more thickness. But if you use the XPS insulation, you will have to put the minimum thickness, but the costing will be high. So this is your concern. Optimize that what kind of my cost it is. So they approved all the things that any kind of insulation you can use, but green building or the ECBC only talks about values. It don't talk about any technology. If this technology should be used, they says only value. Similarly, a lot of people having a myth that LED should be used in green building. They talk about lighting power density. So they any code directly cannot say that this product should be used or this technology should be used. This says with the value, if you are meeting a value, your any product can be can do that.
So I think we'll take one last question. So Mr. Hars is asking, how much can natural ventilation offset the requirement of air conditioning in factory environment, since the volume of air is very large?
Right. So I think this is the most of the factories in India still are the they are not an air conditioned building. They are more air cooled building, which is called an air washer, with the help of that to control the humidity to control something like that. So natural ventilation is required. So already in the NBC National Building Code also says that minimum openable area from the floor we have to provide. natural ventilation purpose. So if you are making a factory, you still can do the natural ventilation, and the temperature around 32 to 33 degree in the inside of the building is achievable. But if you want that your temperature should inside the building is 24, 25 degree with the natural ventilation, it's not possible. So, but thermal comfort range, when we talk about the comfort range, sometimes for the natural ventilated building says the 33 degree centigrade is also, if you meet it, you are in the comfort category for the employees who are working there. So it is, the natural ventilation is required.
So I think there are a lot of other questions. So there are questions which is related to whether sharing the presentation or this link. So I am taking up all the questions. So yes, all the videos of this webinar along with the presentation will be shared to all the registered email ID. In case if you have joined this webinar directly without registration, you can send a mail to cmore@aisglass.com and we'll be sending you this presentation and the recorded session of this webinar. There are some questions, common questions which has come on the regarding high performance glasses. So there are different type of high performance glasses which are available, which is in clear, green, blue, gray or bronze or different colors. So mainly it is clear, green or blue. And basis the performance, it is categorized in solar control double OE or solar control thermal insulation kind of product. So yes, as Mr. Gupta has explained that whenever you are going for such kind of glass selection, you can reach out to the glass manufacturer. They will be able to guide you on right kind of product, different type of options which is available. And all the consultants what definitely we have who can suggest the right kind of products on the same. So yes, whatever questions which we are not able to answer today, so we will be sending the answers over mail, and you can also post your questions over mail which you couldn't ask today. And I would like to thank every one of you to join this session, and I hope that you enjoyed it, and we'll keep on having this session. And thank you so much, Mr. Gupta, for such a wonderful session. So it was indeed a great, great session, and it motivated us to do such kind of session in future as well.
Thank you so much, AIS team and the Shailesh ji for inviting me, and look forward to have a green future, because you glass contributed a lot. And I would suggest you please do the similar kind of session for the architects and the your community. Reason, because whenever I design a project, this is the basic always question comes from how we select a glass, and these three value the people has to understand pretty thoroughly. Thank you so much, AIS team.
Thank you everyone for joining. Thank you, everyone.